But is it soundproof or is it sound treated? Is it acoustically treated or is it soundproof? Hey guys, so I'm actually prepping to move right now. I'm moving my whole studio to a new location, so things are a bit chaotic over here. So what I'm going to do today for my video is just chat about something that's kind of been a pet peeve of mine over the years, and that's the idea of soundproofing versus sound treatment. All right, so there's the idea of something that's completely soundproof, and then there's the idea of acoustic treatment, sound treatment, treating a room, good acoustics, that kind of thing. So the reason why I bring this up is because I'll tell you a story. So I worked in one of the biggest studios in San Diego for years, and it might arguably be the biggest studio in San Diego in terms of like square footage and number of rooms and stuff. I'm not sure. But anyway, at one point, this might have happened a couple times, but at least at one point, the studio manager answered the phone and someone asked if our rooms were soundproof. And he said, yes. And I was like, that's not true. They're not soundproof. So soundproof means that no sound escapes the room at all. There's no sound that can get in. There's no sound that can come out. It's soundproof. Sound cannot pass through. It's secure against sound, right? And that's usually not what recording studios are. And that's usually not what we're going for when we're making a recording space, right? So there's soundproof and then there's, you know, sound treatment. There's acoustic treatment. There's good acoustics. There's sound treatment. You know, we call it a few different things. We describe it using different terms, but these two concepts are not the same thing. And a lot of people seem to be confused about the two. And I get it. Like the manager, the whole idea was that this person was probably asking if we had rooms that were acoustically treated. But in my mind, at that point, why don't you take a moment to actually educate the client about the difference between the two, because there's a small chance that they actually are asking for something that's soundproof for some reason. And if that's the case, then you haven't communicated with them properly, right? So I always think it's better to be, since you're the professional, be the one that's kind of like a stickler about actually using terms correctly so that you actually know that you're having good communication with whoever you're talking to. So with soundproofing, we're actually using different methods to make the space actually soundproof. The idea is to put barriers in place so that the sound cannot pass from one space to another, you know, whatever that space may be. Whereas with sound treatment, we're often just trying to focus on the single space and making that space sound good for whatever purposes we want it for. So, you know, in something like a vocal booth, that might mean making the space very dead, putting a lot of absorptive material in the sound booth to make it a more dead space. Whereas in something like a big live room in a recording studio, we're going to want to have a little bit more natural reverb, have it be a little more lively, a little less absorptive material in there. So sound treatment, acoustic treatment is all about making whatever that one space is sound good for whatever purpose that may be, right? Whereas soundproofing is preventing any sound from moving from space A to space B. So when we're doing soundproofing, we often have to think about ways to prevent bass from going through walls and through objects, right? So we actually have to be a little more intense about putting up stuff that actually blocks the sound completely. Whereas with acoustic treatment, with sound treatment, we can focus more on the single space that we're in and think about things like absorption, reflections, diffusion, stuff like that. Whereas with sound treatment, with acoustic treatment, we're focusing more on things that make that one space sound good. So I actually have a video that's about this, I believe, and I'll put that in the cards somewhere. But the basic idea, right, is you're using things like absorption, diffusion, and bass treatment to actually make that one space sound good. And you know, in studios, we do often have some degree of soundproofing. So for example, the barrier between the control room and the live room, that's almost always going to have some level of soundproofing. It's not necessarily perfect, so it's not completely soundproof. That wouldn't be an accurate way of saying it, but it is there. So yeah, that's the basic idea. I'm sure this video isn't super long, but I just wanted to put it out there because it's been a pet peeve of mine, and I know a lot of people aren't clear on the difference between acoustic treatment and sound treatment and then soundproofing. So that's all I have to say. I don't know. All right, so I'm going to go get things rolling on this move. I'll probably film some of it, so there might be some content on moving a studio coming up in the future. Let me know if you want to see that. Other than that, I hope this video doesn't feel too rushed. I'd love to hear if this is a topic that has bothered you in the past, if you've noticed that a lot of people don't seem to know the difference. I'd love to hear about it in the comments below. And as always, if you like this video, please like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell. I'd appreciate all of that stuff. And I do have a Patreon, so it's patreon.com/ @CatoNoise. And my patrons do get access to additional content. We have a Discord server as well where we're, you know, sharing work with each other. We're talking about audio stuff, nerding out. We have a little book club on there. So it's been a lot of fun. So please feel free to check that out. And other than that, I come out with new videos every Wednesday. And thank you for watching.
Okay.